What's up, Bones and Code Tribe? We are actually going to a really cool event today. It is the Round Rock Express Baseball Bark Event. Bring your dog to the baseball game. So
Woo!
We're super pumped about it. And come on, let's go check it out.
Let's go check it out.
It's our company, it's a local oxygen company, and make like treats and supplements for dogs. So this is a raw goat milk.
Benny,
really?
Yeah, it's just it's good for like health, antibiotic, hydration.
Yeah, there's only one number three.
You might take a photo, is that cool?
No, go for it.
Oh.
First one, all of them?
Yeah, I think we got one for everybody.
Hey buddy, look.
Hi.
Sorry, Riggs. What are their names?
Maggie, Frankie, and Jersey.
Is this Frankie over here?
So this is Jersey.
Jersey.
This is Frankie, Maggie, and Marco.
Jersey. Sit, Maggie.
Hi. Marco, sit.
Marco,
sit. Jersey.
She's 11.
Whoa.
Good boy, Marco.
How old?
Four months.
4 months, I figured, yeah.
Yeah, he's a little shy.
Hi. It's okay to be shy. It's okay. Round Rock Express baseball game with Bones and Co.
And our dogs.
Which we'll show you.
Can't see. They're right down here.
We'll show you in a minute. But we're gonna do, as promised, our very first Q&A video ever.
I'm excited.
Yep. So excited. So we asked you guys to ask us questions. I have them right here, and then we're just gonna answer them in front of all of these people looking at us. It's awesome.
Nice baseball fans.
Yep.
Don't mind the noise behind us.
Yeah. Please ignore that. So first question we have is from Zilker Bark. We'll actually link him down below. Has some really good pictures for you guys to check out. Zilker Bark asks, would love to know more about how you select your ingredients. This would be great info for dogs. So Ryan, the founder, how do we select our ingredients?
It's a great question. So ingredients for us is all about the beginning stages of product quality. So we spend a lot of time sourcing quality ingredients. It's our most important thing that we do. Basically, we look for grass-fed, free-range, cage-free, antibiotic-free meats. And that's for both poultry and our beef and our lamb. And yeah, we work with local farmers and we try to source local as much as possible. Everything's within a day's drive of Austin except our duck, and that comes from the Northeast. We work with a great small family farm up there. But in general, yeah, we're working with small family farmers who are doing it the right way. And actually later this year, we want to do some more stories on those farmers because they have really cool stories of how they're farming our food.
Yep. Good job, Ryan. This is his first Q&A ever, so he's doing good. The next question is from A. Dixon 38. And A. Dixon asks, will we ever be able to order online?
That is a great question. All of our food is frozen, so we actually work with just independent pet retailers in California, Nevada, Texas, Louisiana, and we're expanding, so keep your eye out on our social media pages for some more info on that. But yeah, your local mom and pop retailer in any of those states will carry our food, and it's a great way. There's also local small businesses as well, so we can support those guys, and you can go in and they'll have freezers there. And if it's not in your local store, you can actually ask them to special order it, and they can talk with their distributors about getting our products to you.
Yes.
It's a good question.
And if you want to find some of our food near you, I'll have a link down below. It's just thebonesandco.com/stockists, so you can find out where we sell. Next person asks, and this is Jefferson Weichel, what is the most cost-effective way to feed raw? Go.
Yeah, so raw feeding is more expensive than your grocery store kibble, but the benefits are numerous, and what we like to say, you're investing in your dog's health. So you'll be spending a little bit more money feeding raw, but in the long-term health costs of your animal and the quality of life will be way higher. So for us, what we recommend, if you have a large pack and money is a consideration, you can really get an economical bang for your buck by supplemental feeding. We recommend 20 to 30% on top of your dog's kibble, and it goes a long way in terms of getting the nutrition that they need that kibble just because it's shelf stable can't afford. So the raw nutrients on top of the kibble, great way to go, 30%, good bang for your buck.
Absolutely. And one thing I recommend, if you're feeding kibble, the most important thing you do, if you can only feed kibble, is to add some kind of hydration to it. Whether that's raw goat milk, some of our Bark Boost, which is like a green smoothie for dogs, at the very minimum, you want to add that hydration into the food to help with dehydration. Okay, next question is from Katie Berger. Thank you so much for asking your question, Katie. And she wants to know if we're ever going to come out with a goat line.
Goats. It's been asked before. We have requests for lots of different specialty proteins, and they can be great quality ingredients, but we have a hard time finding farmers and suppliers that are up to our quality standards. So we haven't found one yet, but when we do, we'll definitely consider it. But yeah, especially if your dog has allergens, exotics are a great way to feed.
And while we don't have goat right now, we do have duck, which is a really good option for allergies. Next question at the baseball park is from Valerie Vasic. Sorry if I say that wrong. Valerie asks, do you see yourself expanding to cat food?
Ooh, good question. So number one complaint at Bones & Co. is why don't we do cat food? And primarily is we're a small company, and so that's something we really want to get into because cats obviously deserve the same nutrition that dogs do, and the stuff we're crafting can also be applied to cats. But a lot of raw food companies will do what we call a combo or two-in-one, so they're food. It can be fed to dogs or cats, but that is not our philosophy or our vision. Like, we feel cats are a different species of animal and they need a different type of food. So when we launch our cat food, it's going to be specifically designed for cats. And yeah, you'll see that coming down the road.
Yep. Basically, when we do it, we want to do it right. Next question is from Alex Hopes, who asks, what got you into dog food? I love your story, man.
Cool. Yeah, that's a great question. Basically, Rigsby, he's right here. He was the founding reason for Bones & Co. So we actually adopted him from Awesome Pets Alive, which is the largest no-kill animal shelter in the U.S. Big shout out to our hometown shelter.
APA.
But yeah, so he was abandoned as a pup, and we were trying to bring him back into health. Like, he had a whole host of health issues, wasn't digesting his food. And it was really important for us to find something that would work, to put weight on, have solid stools that help him digest the food and give him the nutrition to help heal. And we went through a ton of different food options, and like a lot of pet parents were pulling our hair out because we had this responsibility to bring him back to health because like we were making decisions on his food. And so we went through a bunch of different kibbles, went through a couple different vets. We finally started crafting our own raw food out of frustration, basically, is a need that we needed. And we started feeding him raw food and had this amazing experience with it. So it was really cool to see how he transformed his health. And then friends and family started asking us for food as well. And we were finally trying to figure out how we could afford to feed it. So we started Bones & Co., feeding local companies around.
All right. So that is going to be it for our first ever Q&A video. If you have more questions, comment them down below and we'll make another video.
Yeah, so we'll see you guys next time.
Okay, bye.